What's up guys, it's Tracker707, and today I'm going to be showing you how to replace the GBA Wireless RX with the new, just wireless RX board that now supports the X and Y buttons for the DS. I reached out to Inside Gadgets and they sent these over to me for free to make videos on them, so thank you guys so much for doing that. The link to everything I use will be down in the description below, and let's get started. First, remove the door to the battery compartment with your Phillips head bit, then take out the battery. Next, remove the 7 tri-wing screws around the shell with your Y bit, then take off the back of the shell. Now, switch to your Phillips head bit and remove the 4 Phillips head screws that are holding down the motherboard. To remove the ribbon cable, start by flipping up the black latch and then gently pull out the ribbon cable with your tweezers. Next, for the smaller ribbon cables that are for the touchscreen, start by pushing back on the black plastic pieces that hold the ribbon cables in place. Once they are pushed out, you can gently pull out the ribbon cable. Do the same thing for the ribbon cable for the top screen. Flip the black plastic piece up and then pull out your ribbon cable. Now, remove the Wi-Fi antenna. Once everything is disconnected from the motherboard, you can pull it out of the shell. Next, we need to remove the old GBA Wireless RX chip from the board. Start by taking off the pieces of Kapton tape that was holding it down to the board, then you can desolder all the wires. These are the lengths of the wires you will need for the L and the R buttons. Start prepping the wires for the L and R buttons by stripping the ends of the wires to reveal the copper. I don't have a wire stripper that's small enough, so I just use a pair of fingernail clippers. Now, tin the ends of the wires. Add flux to the wireless RX PCB, then add solder to each of the pads. Now, take the white wire for L and solder it down to the corresponding point on the board. Then, take the black wire for R and solder it down to its corresponding point. I would recommend taking off any Kapton tape you have holding the wires in place, so then it's easier to maneuver them around while soldering them to the new board. Take the new wireless RX board and solder down all the wires to their corresponding points. After all the wires are soldered down to the wireless RX board, hold it in place with some Kapton tape. Now, flip the board over and solder the black wire for R to the point P08. Next, we can take the white wire for R and feed it through the hole for the ribbon cables. Once it's on the other side of the board, solder it down to the point P09. Now that the two new wires are soldered into place, we can take some Kapton tape and tape down the wires so that they won't interfere with any screw or post holes. All the wires are taped into place, we can take the DS motherboard and put it back into the shell. Use your tweezers to feed the ribbon cable for the bottom screen and the digitizer through their hole on the motherboard. When you push the motherboard down, make sure that none of the ribbon cables or the wireless antenna is trapped under the board. Now, we can take our four Phillips head screws and tighten them down into the board in a cross pattern to make sure to apply even pressure to the motherboard. reattach the Wi-Fi antenna and then tape the wireless RX port back into place. Now, we can reconnect the ribbon cable for the top by making sure that the latch is open and then pushing in the ribbon cable gently to its slot. To ensure that the ribbon cable seated correctly, make sure that the black line from the ribbon cable lines up with the white line on the DS motherboard. Then flip the latch shut. Now, insert the ribbon cable for the digitizer into its slot. Make sure that it's pushed in all the way and then push the black clip shut. Now, just like for the top screen ribbon cable, insert the ribbon cable for the bottom screen into its connector and make sure that it's lined up correctly with the white line on the motherboard. Once it is, push the clip shut. If you took off your L and R buttons, make sure to put them back in before putting on the back of the shell. Finally, before putting on the back of the shell, make sure that any of the wires coming around the board will not be pinched by the two halves of the shell. Now, put the two halves of the shell together, again making sure that any of the wires coming around the board will not be pinched when you close the shell. Screw down the back of the shell with the 7 Y-bit screws. Put your battery back into the console and then screw down the battery door. If you have the DSTX cart, then the instructions for that will be down in the description. But if you only have the GBATX cart, then here's how you would upgrade it to be able to use X and Y. Take your GBX cart and attach it to your GBA Wireless TX cart. Then, attach it to your computer with a USB-C cable. Now jump over to your desktop and launch the Flash GBX software. The link to that will be in the description. Once that's open, switch it over to the Game Boy Advance mode and click Write ROM. Select Try Generic Type and then write the ROM file that I'll have linked in the description. Once it's finished, select OK, and then disconnect the GBX cart from your computer. Now that we have everything, we can test that all the buttons and everything work. So first, I'm just gonna check here that all the buttons and stuff work on the DS. I'm just using a testing software here, I'll link it in the description too for you guys. But we can see all the buttons work there. So now we can also have our wireless controller with our, through our GBA, and test that all the buttons work through there. So you can see that all the buttons are being pressed, even when I'm not touching the DS. If you hold L and R and you click B, then the Y button will be selected. And then if you hold L and R and then A, the X button will work. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe and leave a comment down below if you decided to do this mod or plan to do this mod. I love hearing people's stories if my tutorials help them in any way, so please just let me know down in the comments. I just wanted to thank InsideGadgets again for sending this out to me. I love the work that you guys do and the mods you create, so thank you. I hope you like this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.